in September of 2021, we went on a trip to Iceland and we hiked up a hill and I couldn't breathe. And then the next day, I fell out of a kayak and it felt like I was suffocating.
He couldn't get back into the kayak, which should have been a very easy thing for him to do. And he was having trouble breathing, and he's in great shape. I was surprised and didn't know what to make of it, really.
So when I went home, I visited a doctor and he noticed my muscles were twitching. And he brought in the head of neurology at the hospital, and that guy off the bat said he thought I had a 3 in 5 chance of having ALS. Now, they knew that my dad and uncle had died of ALS.
Had he not had that familial history, we could have wandered in the desert for a while before concluding that it was ALS.
Amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, otherwise known as ALS, is a disorder that's characterized by progressive paralysis of muscle due to the death of the nerve cells that control those muscles.
Someone living with ALS over time will lose the ability to walk, talk, eat, swallow, and eventually breathe.
One of the mysteries of ALS, it's very hard to diagnose. And so often patients don't even recognize what they have until it's been far advanced.
The typical patient after diagnosis lives 2 to 5 years, which is devastating. But we are on the precipice of hope.
The Accelerating Medicines Partnership for ALS is a private-public partnership that brings together the best scientists at the NIH with their counterparts in academia, in the private sector, and in patient research organizations.
Pulling our resources together and collaborating in a pre-competitive space allows us to do something at a scale that no one can do by themselves.
The main challenge in developing therapies for ALS is the lack of a strong scientific knowledge of the underlying pathophysiology of the disease.
We know the disease is extremely heterogeneous, whether it's the cause, the site of onset, the rate of progression. These are all challenges, especially when we're trying to identify a homogeneous subset of the population to ensure that we can evaluate drugs.
The goal of AMP-ALS is to enable scientists to look at the data that's coming in from multiple ALS studies to try to find target identification. So that would be a molecular pathway that shows up in the blood, in the spinal fluid, in the brain tissue that can be the target for an intervention. The second goal is to develop biomarkers.
Biomarkers might help us diagnose ALS early. They also can give clues to the rate of progression and certainly help us determine when a patient is responding to a medicine or is not responding to a medicine.
AMP-ALS is trying to address all these challenges. First, we are putting together the ALS Knowledge Platform. This is going to be the largest data portal where researchers from academia, from industry can go and have access to all the data. Second is the All ALS Natural History Study. This is going to be part of the AMP for ALS. Through that, we're going to have several biospecimens that are going to be used for biomarker research. This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. There are a lot of organizations working in ALS, and they're doing a fantastic job. However, if we play all together, our impact is going to be exponential.
The entire industry is coming together to solve this disease. Everyone believes that this will be, in time, a tractable disease. I just hope the discoveries will be made in my lifetime.
It's a disease that affects him, but it also obviously affects me deeply. You know, we've been through a lot together, but this is a very different kind of challenge. I think there's the hope in the ecosystem. You know, there's the hope that actually there will be therapies that can help people live with ALS for long periods of time. The other message of hope is to take each day as it comes, to get the most you can out of every day you have.